Welcome back to Zero to Hero. I'm back again. That's right. It's the first time I've done this where I've done back-to-back episodes recording. But for this one, it's not anything too intense, or I don't need any feedback or suggestions from people just to make stuff. So trust me, I'm not too bothered on this one. All right, here's what we're doing. We are making everything in Tier 1 into emblems, and we're just going to have a little bit of fun with these. I know it's going to take me a little bit of time to figure out all of the materials. Oh, I'll just put them all in, why not? Because I do not have that many Flutterflies still, unfortunately. Aetherblade, sure. Great. But I'm just going to shuffle things around, make new materials. That's something I actually need to make a few of later on, so that's good. I'm not going to do it right now, though. Is there a combination I haven't tried? Yes, there is. Aether cannon. So these are just like tier 1 weapons, pretty standard things. That's fine. I'm going to swap out the eyeballs for flutterflies. Dune Rider. Recruit. I've done that one. Don't do that one. Done that one as well. Okay, yeah, that's fine. We're going to swap out the flutterflies for... actually, no, we need them in. Put the eyeball emblems in. Done that one. Done that one. Haven't done this one. Arc fire. That's another gun. Typhoon 9. Pyroclasm. That's not a bad staff. Soul Reaver. Not a bad gauntlet. I think that's it for these. Now we swap out this one for that one. Vorpal armor. That's better than my armor. Infinitely better than my armor. Boom! Get out of here. Which normally means I'm not that far from the Vorpal hood as well, I think. That's Nautilus helm, not what I needed. Don't need flowers. Right, I'm going to take the flutterfly emblems back under my wing. Call that good for right now. I do need to get some more materials for those. But you can see here, armor and stuff's different, but for the weapons, there should be two swords, two lances, two guns, two cannons, two gauntlets, two staves. So I've got all the weapons. I'm missing a shield. I've got the two droids. And then I think there's... I think there's six helmets. There might only be four, though. Hang on, there's three tiers, and there's six of these. So it's only four. So I'm missing one piece of armor and one helmet. And that's it. So I'm missing the Nautilus armor and the Vorpal helmet. And then one extra shield here. And that's it. That's pretty much all the tier 1 stuff done. Like, it's not that difficult. I've got to go and get some more Flutterflies. I'm going to do a couple of runs of the Desolate Canyon just to get those. But what I am going to do while I'm here as well is start making use of the scrap metal. So I'm going to keep one and then trash the rest. Scrap metal is actually worth 2 credits, which means as you collect it, and you get it quite commonly from a few of the bosses. I think it's from the... It's World Fragments from... The Hollow Caverns from the Rock Scarab. I can't actually remember where you get it from. It might be Uruk-Gorak. Either way, it pops up from one of the bosses pretty commonly, so it's not like a hard drop to get a lot of. And being able to sell it for a lot of credits is really, really useful. And I'm going to sell these as well, because the extra credits won't go amiss here. Right. So I've got nearly 10,000 credits. The stacks actually cap out at 9,999. What I'm going to do is just quickly upgrade one of these, and then that should be it for now that I can actually afford. This seed emblem is nothing I'm collecting right now, unfortunately. I've got 24 of them basically anyway. That world fragment is not going to see any use at all. These world fragments, I should say, not that world fragment. I don't care about stamina packs. Let's quickly see if there's anything else in here that I need to do. Yeah, there's going to be no tier 1 stuff I need to figure out. Tier 2 stuff, though, I can give another go. Let's quickly do these while I have them. I've done that one. Done that one. Well, yeah, I haven't. It's just telling me I've done it. What am I missing? Hello? There we go, there's one. I think that one was one as well. No, it wasn't. Okay. That might actually be all of them done, to be honest. Shroom. That's the wrong way around. There we go. Quickly check. Yeah, so there's going to be two recipes for each of the tiers of stuff you can put into here. All these are is basically you make more health pack ones and more mana pack ones and more stamina pack ones. And in that case, it's just the anti-poison potions, which we've been using before. And we make more of those just by using like slightly different materials. So now I shouldn't ever really need tier one stuff. All I'm going to do is basically collect a few more flutterflies. And when I'm done with that, I'm going to basically turn all of these into just more gear that I've already made to be able to get it in better quality, which gives me a few extra stats. It's not a huge upgrade, but it's going to be something that at least then I can burn through materials in a meaningful way and end up with something slightly more productive at the end of it than just throwing it away into the abyss, as I did with Percival's wand. So this is just a flutterfly run. All I'm doing is literally just going to click on stuff, run around, and leave. That's it, honestly. Like, there is no other point to me being here anymore. It still provides experience, but it's not a huge amount. So for me, I am not too fussed about it. Right, it's going to give me a bit of bother here. There we go. Like I said, I get a little bit of experience. I can talk to Ringabot as well. He might give me some good potions. Give me... There we go. Health pack 2. Not bad. Perfect. Let's get one of these as well. I'll always open a chest if I see it, just for reference. All these portal uses are coming out like crazy now. I always open a chest if I see it, purely because it makes it easier to get rings, because the more opportunities you take, like obviously the better chances you have to get something from them. But there is a trick to getting rings, kind of. I can't really show it just yet because I haven't unlocked everything for it, but when I do, I will show you some tips and tricks for just improving the game in general, like after you've got to a specific point, when you've unlocked a few more things. And I mean that, like, augments and stuff aren't just for making your character stronger, it's for like ease of collection and ease of you know, a lot of things in the game, actually. I don't actually care where this goes because it's not enough experience for it to be meaningful. It's a second bubble that I don't need. Hey, a ring! I got one! Alright, that's actually really good. The Azarius ring gives me magic, which is actually what I need it for, so that's actually perfect. I need that for the build in general. A faith ring would be okay, but this gives me a little bit of faith, and it's actually, like I said, a really, really good drop, so I'm not too bothered. Hey, space pirates! Okay, cool. That's some free experience. Oh yeah, buddy. There we go. They're worth killing. Oh, and a meteor shower! Look at me! I'm so spoiled! I am going to cheat a little bit. Alright. I've taken a null damage potion. I've never used this before. The null damage potion itself basically halves all incoming damage for the duration, which is 5 minutes. Which is actually really good against bosses and stuff that you haven't fought before and you might be a little bit risky, might find a little bit risky to fight, but trust me, no big deal. And if I need to, I'll pop my bubble. And this way, even if I don't dodge stuff, I won't die. It's cool. I'm just making myself as safe as possible because I have lost characters to meteor showers when I was a new player. Null damage potions are really cheap and accessible, so if you have, you know, the resources and it is just tier 1 stuff, make them, please. You're not going to use them all the time, especially like early on. I mean, if you want to, you can, and it'll like halve how difficult the game is. I was thinking if that was the correct way to say it, and it actually is. Like, it will make it, you know, twice as easy or half as hard, which is, you know, if you want to do that, that's your prerogative. The meteor shower has actually passed already, so for me, you know, no problem, it's done. But yeah, trust me, it's not something you want to get caught in and caught off guard in specifically. So I don't mind using an old damage potion that I can just make another one of, like it's nothing, because that's what I'm going to be doing with the remainder of my tier 1 gear from here, after I've already made the emblems and stuff that I need. I did 100 on a crit. Wow. Perfect. Have I got the hero uniform on? I have. I couldn't remember. Right. That's all the runs I'm going to do. For right now, at least. I'm just going to put it again. Whatever. I don't really care. See if there's anything here that's worth picking up. Flutterfly emblem is definitely worth picking up. And a flutterfly. Why not? Alright. And crucially, I've just got another card. Which I can sell. I can sell! There we go. And put me over the 5,000 mark again, which means I can now improve my ship droids a little bit more as well. Make this one from the other end, just to mess with people's OCD in case they have it. So yeah, the final upgrade from these is an entire stack of credits, which I don't have right now, but there is a trick to getting pretty easily, but I'm not going to do that just yet because it is a little bit risky. In any case, let us go and make a bunch of emblems here. I really did not put these back in order. Wow. Like, what I'm going to do is basically just... I've got plenty of these, I don't need to make more. I'm just going to use all of those. And hopefully that should put me in enough position. In fact, I think it should get me enough to finish up all of the recipes. Let's try just these three. Where was the shield? There's the shield. Okay, clearly not it. A lot of the materials for specific recipes actually are very similar. And I'll show you in that second call. That's the other shield for tier one. And what was the other one? I don't care if they're in order right now. So you can kind of see here, these two swords are planet, blank, eyeball. And you change out what it is in the middle. This one is planet, eyeball, blank. Here again, you can kind of see that this stays constant, the other two change. This stays constant, the other two change. Constant, constant. You can see that there's like something in common with a lot of the recipes. So if you're ever a little bit lost, but you've figured out one or two of them, you can kind of, you know, figure it out. Helmets and armor aren't as simple, but you can see on this for the what's it called, recruit armor and the recruit helmet, which are the first tier one ones. You'll find that is basically the reverse of each other, right? And you can see here as well, reverse of each other. So what I need to do is I need to do herb, eyeball, flutterfly. What does that give me? Herb, eyeball, flutterfly. Not figured out. Purple hood, which is actually what I needed. This is actually, you know, still good, but not as good for me as the purple hood is. And then the other one, I'll take these back out. So again, you can see here, this and this. Is that right? Is that where I was going? These two are reversed at the very least, and these two are very similar to these because they're reversed completely. So I did flutterfly, herb, creature. Flutterfly, herb, creature is not what I did at all. I'm so confused. What was the point of that? Either way, I figured it out somehow, right? I did it. It's fine. So let's do this one as well. So the armor is going to have to be like the only combination I haven't really used that amounts to anything. Again, I'm stabbing in the dark. I could look these things up on the wikia, like I could, and just get all the recipes straight away, because making them all is important. But there's no point, right? Nobody's going to follow that as a new player, so I'm just going to, you know, act like a buffoon for a little bit, if that's okay. But I'm trying to figure this one out. It doesn't matter, I can't just do trial and error. But there'll be something in common with those ones, because these have something in common as well. I think... Let's try flutterfly, herb, eyeball. Flutterfly, herb, eyeball. Nope. I'm just stabbing in the dark at this point. I think I've got everything with the planet emblem. I think I've got everything with these because I have these the most materials at the very least. Let's keep going until I find something I haven't done. I swear I would have checked all of these now. But I haven't. Of course I haven't. There we go. Perfect. Right, so that's Nautilus armor. So, just for the tier 1 stuff I have left, I want to make a tier 1 gear in better quality. Better quality stuff is easier to obtain using a blacksmith character, something that you get from reaching level... It might be like 70 or 75, and then probably an Iron Man, I think, but... I don't have that right now. This was an account with nothing on it when we started, so I'm going to make more copies of the Mage Gauntlet because there is a particular weapon I want. So what I'm going to do is just make it repeatedly. That's a rare. I'll keep that in case I get nothing better. In terms of rarities, there are four. I've mentioned this briefly because of the Percival's one being a legendary item. But legendary is the highest. Then underneath that there's epic, underneath that there's rare, underneath that there's common. The colours are yellow, then purple, then blue, and then just like this like dark blue, like grey colour, basically. And I'm out of the material that I needed. I can make what's left of these anyway into a few more emblems. Because I have made a significant upgrade anyway. I have three more attempts, and then I am totally donezo, yo. The chance to get good gear from this isn't exactly, like, high. It's possible, by all means. I managed to get two rares out of that, and these are... You can see, this is level 1, this is level 6, and the stats are marginally different, so that's out of here. This is in there. I've got an epic one of those, which kind of shows that it is possible. And I'm going to make a few more of these with what I've got left. There we go. And that's kind of it for tier 1 stuff. Like, I don't need it for anything else. See what's left to make with the gear I've got left here. Let's just pop those in. I don't need a pyroclasm staff. I don't need that gauntlet. I don't need that sword. Don't need that lance. Don't need that gun. Don't need that cannon. Alright, so nothing is really useful. Watch it make like 7 legendary things. Pyroclasm, don't really need it. Get out of here. Nah, Soul Reaver's useless as well. Right, these are gone. Gone forever. Don't need them. Everything's moving up a space. This is a point of progression for me. As much as death is important in this game, I also find that, you know, figuring things out in terms of how to make certain items is also really, really important, and you'll probably find that if you're playing it as well. So what I'm going to do here, I don't know why I've come down, is actually do a few things with some of this tier 2 stuff, because I have a few, you know, tier 2 mats. So I'm going to sort of figure out just a decent midpoint for a lot of these, and then make... no, I'll make it up to 80, because I don't really need them. Here we go. And then just make a bunch of these. And reset those. I had to separate that to have an odd number rather than even, so that I'll be able to get a few more emblems. And I can make some tier 2 stuff as well. I don't want to make too much tier 2 stuff, because I don't necessarily need it. And I want to keep one of everything here, but it's not going to hurt to make a few things, try a few things out. Hey! That's not bad! Obsidian is actually the droid that I needed, so I'm going to make a few more of those. Boom! Get out of here. Probably not going to get legendary ones again, though. I need to fill something out with those. But yeah, where is my droids? There are my droids. Another one of those. Click. And another one of these. Click. So yeah, I've got legendary one, which is kind of cool. I'll put it in the middle. Make it look kind of nice. This, for itself, gives me magic and faith, which is really good because I do need magic, and I can actually turn this into an ultimate droid, which gives me additional magic. The stats granted by these are a new addition in 1.5, the patch we're on right now. So as you can imagine, like, it's not exactly been around for a long, long time. I'm not actually aware of what all the droids' names are, because I don't need to know them. Like, in the past, the only ones I picked up were, like, Megazord, because it was cool. And that was about it. Like, there's not a lot, really, to know about them, and the stats that come from them, again, I'm not too familiar with, but at the same time, you can use the wiki to help you out. So either way, that's much further down the line. Much further down the line. I need to stifle a sneeze again. Okay, I'm okay, I think he thinks. Okay. It's really unsatisfying, but I really don't want to sneeze because I have to cut it out in the audio, which is really not that fun. So right, what's next? Tier 2 stuff, that's what I was doing. So let's do Orichalcum, Beetle, and this. Doomguard, that's a sword. That is an epic lance. Yep. I can make two more things. The High Wind is another lance. Get over here. And the Flame Lash is a gauntlet. A very good gauntlet, actually. We're going to choose up all the materials, why not? And the Astra is a staff. Right, again, I said I wasn't going to make too much stuff. I'm not going to make another one of those, but I am just going to use these up a little bit. Quickly do one of those. There we go, because I don't have enough monster claws to sustain that. I'll quickly show off the other gauntlet. You can see it's slightly differently shaped projectiles. They'll travel like a different speed, a different range. And then this lance here, they attack in a funny way, but they look kind of cool. And you can do some sweet tricks like that. And this one, if I can ever get it to do it. Yeah, like that as well. There's a few cool tricks with lances, but I'm really not interested in keeping it, to be honest. Which puts me back to sort of like square one here. But like I said before, it puts me in a position where I have tier 2 loot that I need to keep collecting, tier 3 loot which I need to keep collecting, which means I have to move on through the planets. And you can see here the stuff that I've actually collected over the, you know, past few episodes in terms of portal uses. You can see which ones I've visited and which ones I have more access to. The Desolate Canyon now spikes up ahead, which is perfect, it really is. But what I really want to do now is move on to the next planet. And I want to do just one run today, so I don't really want to do it right now. But I am going to go and get a few more Monster Claws, so I'm going to go to my preferred place, which is the Shroom Town, and get some Monster Claws in there. My damage should be a little bit higher now, purely because I have this this armor, which puts my magic up a little bit higher. It means I think I was doing like 60-something last episode, and now we're doing 75. Ow. That was daft of me. That was daft of me. Well, there we go. 75 per hit, which isn't bad at all. Forgot I still don't one-shot everything. Alright. I'd like to be able to one-shot everything. That'd be great. Yeah, shroomies may seem nice, but blah, blah, blah. Shut up, Lenny. I don't need to know that. It's fine. That's an early boss. Oh, okay, I one shot the red ones now. That's good. I didn't realize that. Blue ones, though. No. That portal use? No, it was a blue shroom. Chest. There we go. That's not too bad. Again, tier 2 loot drops everywhere here. Everywhere. So, these guys are going crazy over here. It's making a lot of noise. Let me pick this up. Drop one of these. They are just going crazy. I can just hear them, like, spitting mad bars, you know? Who says that? No one says that. No one sane says that. You see now that I'm using spells a little bit more liberally because I have a lot more mana to play with. I have the full 100 mana. Oh my, I didn't realize. But it does mean that I am actually using mana potions more frequently as well. There is a place where you can grind for free mana potions, free tier 2 mana potions, which grant, is it 12? 15 mana back, which is actually really, really good, especially for Iron Men. So I will probably get to that in the future. But for right now, it's still a bit of a risk to try to get to. And there's like one or two planets in the way, so I'll do those ones first. But I've done the first four. Like, that's the first real test, I suppose. If you really wanted to, and this is not a suggestion unless you want to take it as such, if you are playing an Iron Man character, or indeed any other character at home, accomplishing the first four levels is enough to get you to like level 100 as an Iron Man. It takes a long, long time, but if you wanted to, you could do it. When I hit around about level 40, I have a choice to make, and I am level 33 right now. Ooh, another ring, Gromwell, not useful, but I'll keep it because it's a ring. Again, you kind of take what you're given in this case. Hey man, look, I'm sorry I killed all your friends, alright? It wasn't intentional, they just got in my way, and I wanted their experience. Bye! Right. So, I have a choice to make where basically the character is going to reach a point of, like, not critical mass, but, like, something not far off from that sort of grandiose expression. Basically, the character is going to be at the point where I could unlock the best uniform in the game just by killing it, or I can just struggle a little bit longer as well. So, I want you guys to try me on this one, perhaps. Like, maybe there'll be a poll card that pops up right about now, and you guys can, you know, select, do I kill the character at level 40 and start fresh, or do you want me to continue playing? Because I do want to get to level 100 as well, and I don't know if making an Iron Man character, you know, another Iron Man character, I should say, is necessarily the best idea, although it will streamline the process. And because I've already done something doesn't feel right, which means I'm going to get a meteor shower probably. Because I've already done like some of the stuff, such as unlocking a few like the planets, and I've shown you know, a bully shroom. Oh no. Yeah, because I've already, yeah, meteor shower, perfect. Let me drop one of these again. If you wanted to for meteor showers, by the way, you can just stand in the corner like this and just wait. And then if one comes to you, just jump over it like that. It's a very slow thing to do, but it's a very safe thing to do. So maybe if you want to stay alive during a meteor shower, give it a go. See if it works for you. My bubbles are about to wear off. Right. Either way. So, I could kill the character and basically make another Iron Man. By making another Iron Man at that point, I would be able to get a better uniform, potentially unlock a few extra races. I think I'd unlock a few augments and stuff just by chance as well, which is really good just for the progression of the account. So if you guys want to see that progression continue, I'll kill the character, no problem. But because I have shown you like what I know of all the enemies from the levels I've done so far, I could just streamline the process and just literally just run them. Like, I don't need to tell you how to beat Uragorak. I don't need to mess around for a while. I wouldn't need to worry about I wouldn't need to worry about explaining how poison works or how to avoid or fight certain enemies, because you've seen it all before, right? And at that point I could probably get to this position that I'm in right now in probably 2 episodes, and I'm on episode 5 right now. The only thing that I would need to do is like regrind for gear and possibly start over for the gear I'm getting, but I could have the opportunity to do a different build if I'd like. I do want to kind of see where this one goes, because I just kind of took whatever I was given and ran with that. So it's not like I've necessarily had a hard time figuring out what I was going to do, because I just rolled with the punches in this case. I got a cool race, and that's all that mattered. So I think that's more organic than making, like planning a build out. I have since gone through and planned a build, so if you guys don't want to see it come to, you know, complete fruition, then again, I've got no qualms with it. But if you guys do want to see this character die to see the progression, that's fine. If not, I'll try to go for 100. That's kind of the plan. That's not what I meant to press, so well. That's kind of the plan, to try and get to 100, but trust me, I'm not too fussed, to be honest. I could do it any time. I've done it 3 times before, so... really not a big deal. I don't know how much HP you've got. It's probably 100. Probably. Ow, I jumped into him. Whoopsie. But you see, yeah, I'm really putting a bit of a hurt on my mana here, which isn't great. Another Cromwell ring. That's bizarre. I'm lucky, like really lucky. But again, not a ring I needed, sadly. Alright, you can get out of here, mister. Get out of here. There we go. Alright, let's jump this nest. Get a few final kills. You just no-scoped me. He just... did you see that? He didn't even look at me when he attacked me. Where'd you go? There you are. Like Gandalf. Except the enemy isn't quite as epic. Just falling and fighting. That had some range on it. You got some pipes, my boy? You're nearly dead. I trust. There you go. I ran out of mana, so I was trusted that he was nearly dead. There you go. Boop. And boop. Get over here. Ow. I headbutted him to death. That's what it was. It's not a viable strategy, but I did it. There we go. Right. I'm going to have a little bit more of a play with some of the tier 2 stuff I've collected. I just got the extra monster claws to try and bring it off the exact 10, basically. So that's pretty good. You can see here, this is level 3 compared to the old one, which is level 4, and it has the same stats already. So if that's of any consequence to you, which I know it's not because it's my character, but at the same time, you know, it's all something to keep in mind. Got so many shrooms now, wow. Here we go, back in the ship, safe and sound. How are we doing over here? 4,000, I have some of these as well. Again, I want to keep emptying out those emblems every episode if I can, because I know that they're going to become kind of obsolete. I'll get rid of one of these, I don't need it. They're going to become kind of obsolete in there, and I need the room to keep generating more world fragments. But the higher tier you make the ship droids, the things that generate the world fragments, the more often you're going to see loot that is not... that is not world fragments. And more often you're going to see these emblems pop up. So I do want to kind of get rid of them as and when they pop up if I can. That's a tier 4 piece. I'll keep it down here for now. I don't need it as such, but I'll keep it for now. Because eventually I'm going to move on to tier 4. And it is not harder to get, but obviously it's from harder levels, which changes a little bit of the dichotomy of the system. Actually, no, I'll make this up to 30. Why not? Why the heck not? And we'll I've only got three to play with anyway, so I'm just going to do some of each of these. That'll do. I've got nine of those three and just a few of these. That's no problem. I'm going to halve these as well, because at least then now I've got some more stuff to play with. I said halve. It wasn't perfect. But there we go. Like, I'm just trying to make sure things are tidy and things have their space. The importance of doing this is that then if you collect more of the materials, they go to somewhere and you know where they're going to be. It's purely just for inventory's sake. Like, it's just for keeping things safe. But genuinely, don't worry if you don't do it. But it keeps my head clear to know that everything here is safe. I'm going to do a little bit more crafting as well then. I don't need to make any more emblems. So let's see. Orichalcum. See what we can do with these first, because I've got more of these. An Aegis, that's a cool shield. Titan Helm, that's a interesting one. Isaac Armor, also pretty cool. It's a faith-based one based off of Isaac from Dead Space. Bat 17s, these become the... do they become the Megazords? I think they do. But it's a technology and magic. Wowee! Okay, I've done these, that's fine. So I think I've done these. Is there anything else I'm missing? Oh yeah, there's one. There's one. There's Isaac Helm as well. Right, Shroom. Let's put you in instead. Oops. Vault's Thunder. That's a pretty cool gauntlet. I like that gauntlet a lot. Thornwall. Interesting stuff. But I'm going to keep that Claw Emblem now. And call that a good one, I think. Honestly, this one wasn't too long, I don't think. I've tried to keep these two a little bit more brisk because I've done them together for the last episode and this episode. I don't really want to bulk record these as much as I can because I like to get feedback in between the two. And in this case, like I said, I want to know if you want me to kill off this character when he reaches level 40, which we're on the cusp of doing. So it's really not that far off. It's probably going to be like another two or three episodes at the very, very most, because we are going to pick up a bit more of the action next time. But I do need to level up some of my gear and stuff anyway, so that's likely what I'm going to do in the next episode, and then we'll start going on to somewhere else. Because the weapon is the only thing I've been leveling up, really, but of course I do get additional stats from my helmet and from my armor, and also from this ring now as well. So trust me when I say that there's a lot more to happen with this. I will get a lot stronger over the coming episodes, so level 40 really isn't like that far flung of an idea. And as soon as the droids get to level 10, we're going to start doing some challenge level stuff, hopefully when I'm on my way through all the other levels first as well. Let's quickly have a look. I think I got all the materials for tier 2 stuff, but I didn't do anything for tier 3, so we're going to do that as well. Ore doesn't go into these anyway, so it's pointless. Mana pack 2, perfect. Swap these around. Health pack 2, that is actually great. Ash and dust. Anti-frost. This is very similar to anti-poison, but of course it doesn't reduce poison, it reduces frost on you. Again, I think it's by 50%, not entirely sure. Might not be. Let's have a quick check. I'm missing something. There's a pattern here, so it's going to be loot, herb, or loot plant bug is what it's going to be. So loot plant bug. Oh, well, apparently you're not part of the pattern. Gosh dang darn. Let's try a few more things to just have a quick check, see if we can figure it out. There it is. Energy pack 2. These, again, are the energy packs I've had before, which restore stamina. Kind of useless for me because I have, like, tech coming in from my everything else. A little bit of tech, not a lot, but, of course, tech. Your mana regen, not mana, stamina regen's pretty quick unless you do this. You can see my stamina's draining pretty, really quick, but then as soon as I stop moving around, like, it doesn't take that long to respawn, so it's really not of consequence when you hit over, like, 20, 30 mana. Wow, I keep saying mana, I mean stamina. I'm so sorry. Right, so let me just quickly reorganize these. There we go, that's correct order for everything in the inventory. That's about everything I needed to do. I'm at the point now where I can start to collect tier 3 gear pretty comfortably and be able to make certain things here. But like I said, there's a way we can farm these for free, and I'll show you those in the coming episodes. But next time, I want to make sure I get to the right console here. Next time we're going to take on the Ancient Ruins, I believe. So Ancient Ruins is one of my favourite levels, actually. It has my favourite mob in the entire game, not my favourite enemy, not my favourite NPC. But it is pretty crucial for some of the stuff I've got to do on this account. So we're going to do that anyway and see what happens. But please leave me the feedback about the level 40. Do I kill the character? Do I kill number one and move on to number two? What do we do? Let me know. Obviously, the card will be running through all the episode, but it should have popped up earlier. Excuse me. Wow. I really have just got out of bed. But of course, please, again, tell me any suggestions for the series. I have a lot more on the way. Like, this is only the first character on the entire, you know, series itself. And assuming I get this character to level 40, that's the primary goal I had. The secondary ones were complete the storyline I've got running, and of course, get to level 100 so I can beat the... I can beat the creator in Iron Man mode. That's the ultimate goal. But if you guys want this character to die at level 40, I haven't even started the storyline, so it doesn't really matter, because that's the bit that would have actually taken most, like, not most time, but the most difficult, and it's the most difficult thing to accomplish on this character, that would have taken a bit of effort. So please, please let me know, do I die at level 40 to make things easier for myself, to show the progression that's available in the game, or do we just stick with what we've got, and just try and see how far we can, you know, hang in there and see if we can accomplish everything I'd set out to do. But that really is it for now. Thank you so much for joining me once again, folks. Please look after yourselves, because we'd like to see you again. So until next time, have fun, and bye for now.